read it, then bah, love will appear in their heart. But we see so many times that power of the name is not manifesting. Why? Tabu jani aparada tohite prachur. Krishna nama bija tahi na kare ankur. If the seed of the holy name is not opening, then we should know that we have so many aparad, prachur, an abundance of offenses. So it's very difficult to overcome the offenses to the holy name. But fortunately, Supreme Lord Sri Krishna himself and Balaram Prabhu appeared in this world as Gauranitai. Chaitanya Nityananda Nahi Ei Sabha Vichara Nama Loile Prem Dena Bahiya Sudha. In the chanting of the names of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu, there is no consideration of aparad. So those who glorify Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu, quickly they become free from offense. And then when they take the name of Krishna, tears of love flow from their eyes. So first we are singing the names of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu. Now we will take shelter of the names of Hare Krishna, Radha and Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Thank you. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare.
Shri Putram Atra Surupam Rupam Tasagajaru Vipuri Maturingo Shvartim Radha Kunda Magirivaram O Radhika Madhavarsam Rato Yasya Pratipaya Shri Guru Tam Natosmi Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Tadale Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Rad Bhaktaya Namo Namah Anandalila Maya Vigrahaya Hema Bhaktivyatschavi Sundaraya Tasmai Mahaprema Rasapradaya Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namaste Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namaste Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namaste Bhaktya Bhina Aparada Lakshya Chitta namaste charanaravindam Vrinde namaste charanaravindam Govinda namo charanaravindam Govinda Dhamma Paramagadevi Govinda Dhamma Paramagadevi Govinda Dhamma Paramagadevi Hey Krishna, Hey Radha, Hey Sakati Govinda Dhamma
Shama Sundar Shikandashi Smarahasamurli Manara Radhikar Sukamama Kripanidhe Swakriya Charna Kinkurim Kuru Tavaivasmi Tavaivasmi Najivamitayavana Jivikyaya Devi Tam First of all, I offer my Sastangandavat Puspanjali, my heart like flowers thousands of times, at the lotus feet of my holy master, my supremely worshipable spiritual Gurudev, Asmadiya Paramaradhitama. Guru Pada Padma, Nitya Lila Pravishta, Om Vishnu Pari, Ashtodara Satasi Srimad, Rupa Durga Acharya Varya, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Narayana Goswami. Secondly, I offer my pranam thousands of times at the lotus feet of my Karam Gurudev to Srila Prabhupada and to all of our Sri Rupanuga Gaudiya Guru Param. And finally, I offer my pranam to all of my dear Vaishnava brothers and sisters,
Vaishnava namo namaha.
By the causes mercy of Sri Guru and Gauranga, I have the opportunity to have darshan of all the Vaishnavas of New York today. It's my good fortune. Especially because of the love and affection of Bhumipati Prabhu.
Haribo.
And Sudarshan Chakra Prabhu.
Hare Krishna.
Was requesting me again and again to come here. So somehow it happened. And especially I want to thank Krishna Mohan Prabhu and his wife for hosting the program here. I can see that he's very dedicated to Krishna's service. His whole garden is like a Naimisharanya. The place of Bhagavad Katha.
Jai.
See, Jagadananda Pandit, he said, Gaurarami, Mukhe bolile nahi chale, Gaur achar gaur vichar lele phale phale. Many persons, they say, I am Gauriya. I belong to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I am a follower of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. By their mouth, they say. But actually, they don't follow. Because the fruit of being the follower of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will come only Gaura Achar, Gaura Vichar, Lale Phale Phale. When we become immersed in two things, Gaura Achar and Gaura Vichar. Gaura Achar means the example he sets in his life by his behavior. And Gaura Vichar means the deep current of the conception of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did not fully expand, he did not write upon this, but he has empowered his innermost heart's desire into the heart of Srila Rupa Goswami. Therefore, Srila Narottam Das Thakur, he has written, Sri Chaitanya Mano Vishtam,
Sthapitam Yena Bhutare,
Swayam Rupa Kadamayam, Vidati Swapadamitam. When will Srila Rupa Goswami Pai give me the shelter of his lotus feet? He is that person who established within this world the mission to reveal the Mano Vishtam, the innermost heart desire of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What is that? Mano Vishtha of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Our Srila Gurudev, Nipilila Puristam Vishnupada, Ashtodara Satasishima, Rupananga Charivari, Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj. He very enthusiastically, with so much taste, traveled throughout the world to establish the bhakti as expressed by Rupa Goswami, Rupanuga Bhajan. You can see that when it was Radhastami, Srila Gurudev used to organize very beautiful festival in India. When it was Janmashtami, it was a very beautiful festival for Krishna's birthday. But when it came round to the disappearance day of Srila Rupa Goswami, Srila Gurudev would organize a festival for 5 days. More emphasis, even than Janmashtami or Radhastami or Nrisimha Chaturthi, any day, 5 days, symposium he used to make and invite all the Vaishnava scholars in our Gaudiya line and from other sampradayas, from Nimbarka sampradaya, from Vallabh sampradaya, to come and spend the time deliberating upon the revelations of Srila Rupa Goswami. Perhaps you know that when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he met Rupa Goswami in Prayag. There he said, Para para sunya gabir bhakti rasa sindhu, tomai chakai te kahe, tahe kahe ek bindu. Hey Rupa, the ocean of bhakti rasa is para para sunya. It has no shore. You go in the Atlantic Ocean or Pacific Ocean, it's huge. But eventually, if you keep traveling, you get to the other side. But this Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, ocean of rasa, you travel and travel and travel for millions of years, you never get to the other side. It has no shore and it has no bottom. Therefore, Mahaprabhu said, just to make you understand, I will describe a single drop. So Srila Gurudev gave an example. He said, it was as if Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took the finger of Rupa Goswami, dipped it into the ocean of rasa, and then said, taste this. And Rupa Goswami tasted that rasa, and then from that one drop, he manifested all his writings. Ujjwala Nilamani, Lalit Madhav, Vidagra Madhav, Stava Mala, Dhamkeli Komadi, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. All the writings of Rupa Goswami came from that one drop. It's enough to inundate the entire universe. So therefore, Srila Kavikarnapur, glorifying Rupa Goswami, he said, Vrindavaniyam rasa keli vartam kalena luktam nija shakti utkar sanchaya rupe vyatano punasa prabho vidho prahi aloka shishti. He said that Vrindavaniyam rasa keli vartam kalena luktam. The katar of the beautiful rasa-laden pastimes of Sisi, Radha and Krishna in Vrindavan had become lupta. It had become lost. It had disappeared from the world. So, why is that? Srila Vishnu Thakur in his commentary on the first verse of Srimad Bhagavatam, you know there, the first verse, Janma Vyasya Yatan Vayaditaratascha Teshva Vigasana. Tenet Brahma Ridaya Adhikavaye Bhunyanti Yatsu. Is Janma Vyasya. So one of the meanings here is the birth or the appearance of Adi, Janma Adi of Adi Rasa, Madhurya Rasa, the romantic mood of Vrindavan. So Param Satyam Dhimahi, may we meditate upon that Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna, who causes the appearance of the Adiras, the romantic mood, Madhuyaras, in this world. So, a person may say, this Madhuyarasa is eternal, it is Nitya. So, yes, so how can it have a Janma? How can it have a birth? It's an eternal rasa. So in the commentary, Srila Vishnu Thakur explained that yes, though this rasa is eternal, very often it disappears from this world. There's no flow of the katar of Madhurya Rasa. Why? Because of the censorship of very conservative transcendentalists. There are many transcendentalists. They discuss, you are not this body. They discuss the three modes of material nature. They discuss the glories of the Holy Name. They discuss reincarnation. All of these things are very important. But very often, there is a censorship of the Madhurya Rasa. And when that happens, because they are very conservative, that flow of katar, of Radha Krishna's Leela, just disappears from the world. So, therefore, it is said, Vrindavaniyam rasa keli vartam kalena luktam. Gradually in time, the katar of Madhurya Rasa disappeared. At that time, Sancharya Rupe Vyatano Punasa, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu inspired this Madhurya Rasa in the heart of Rupa Goswami in the exactly the same way as in the beginning of the creation, the Supreme Lord inspired the Vedic knowledge into the heart of Lord Brahma. Tene Brahma Ridya Adi Kavaye Bhuyanti Yatsureya. So it's a wonderful thing. It is said that Sri Krishna inspired Lord Brahma at the place called Dashashvamedha Ghat. So now, at the time of Rupa Goswami, that very Krishna has appeared as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and is now doing the same thing, inspiring not the creation of the universe, inspiring not the Vedas, but rather inspiring into the heart of Rupa Goswami the creation of the world of Madhurya Rasa. So Srila Gurudev said, one of the confidential meanings of this first verse of Srimad Bhagavatam, Tene Brahma Hridaya Adi Kavaye, means that it was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu who revealed into the heart of Adi Kavaye, the original poet of Madhurya Rasa, Srila Rupa Goswami. He revealed the Bhakti Rasa into the heart of Rupa Goswami. This is one of the confidential meanings of the first verse of Srimad Bhagavatam. So, Muyanti Yatsuraya means, one, the general meaning is that the demigods, they are bewildered in turn when it comes to understanding what is the Paramatattva. But Surayaha also means devotees. So, it means that when Srila Rupa Goswami spoke his poetry in Jagannath Puri, in the association of Mahaprabhu and his associates, when they heard for the first time the beautiful poetry of Rupa Goswami, they all became astonished and they were fainting in ecstasy. Muyanti Yatsure. You see, Srila Rupa Goswami, after being instructed by Mahaprabhu, he went to Vrindavan. And then from there, he was traveling on foot, nearly 2,000 kilometers, and he was on his way to Jagannath Puri. On the way, he was writing a drama, but he stopped at a village called Satyabhamapur. And there at night, he saw Satyabhama in a dream. And she told him, "Oh Rupa, you should write a separate drama about me." And Rupa Goswami realized, oh, I was writing a drama about Krishna's Leela in Vrindavan, and then how he went to Mathura and how he went to Dwarka. But now she's telling me I should divide it into two parts. And one became Sri Vidagna Madhav Natakam, and the other one Sri Lalit Madhav Natakam. So then Rupa Goswami continued and he arrived in Jagannath Puri. He gave pranams to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And without telling anything to Mahaprabhu about what he was writing or what happened in Satyabhamapur, Mahaprabhu said to him, "O Rupa, Krishna nyo yadu sambhuto, na puna sostata apara, vrindavanam prityajak vachin eva nagacchati." O Rupa, don't take Krishna out of Vrindavan. Because that Krishna who is known as the son of Vasudeva and Devaki, that is another. That's his Vaibhav Prakashi's expansion. Because Krishna Vrindavan, Vrindavanam prityajak, he never takes one step outside of Vrindavan. So then Rupa Goswami, he realized, oh, what Satyabhama told me, now that is being confirmed directly by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. So, Srila Rupa Goswami, when he was in Puri, he used to stay with Srila Haridas Thakur. Perhaps you've been there in Puri to the place, Siddha Bakul. Very wonderful place. Mahaprabhu used to have Haridas Thakur stay there. When I used to go there with Gurudev, Gurudev was very happy. He used to sit down in Siddha Bakul and say, "This is our place." Yeah. This is our place. Why? Because we are followers of Srila Rupa Goswami. So in Jagannath Puri, this is our place because this is the place in Jagannath Puri where Rupa Goswami used to stay. And then he used to tell to us, those who have bodies from the West in this life, he used to say, and especially, it is your place. Why? Because this is the place of all the rejects. Those who have been rejected from the Vedic society, those who cannot go in the Jagannath Puri temple. Actually, the first time Srila Gurudev went to Jagannath Puri, they also stopped him from going in the temple. Because his skin was very fair and his eyes are blue. So not so many Indian persons have the bright blue eyes. So when Gurudev was going into the temple in Jagannath Puri, the Pandas stopped him. "Oh, what is your Gotra? Where are you from? Who is your family line? Everything." And he had to give a long explanation, and they believe, okay, you can see. But we see Srila Haridas Thakur, he could not go inside the Jagannath temple because he was born in a Muslim family. And Srila Rupa Goswami and Srila Sanatana Goswami, also they were not allowed to go in because in their previous career, they had accepted the service in the government of Nawab Hussain Shah. And so they were ostracized from rabbinical culture. So Srila Haridas Thakur would stay there, Rupa Goswami would stay there, Srila Sanatana Goswami, all those who were rejected. So Gurudev said, oh, you Western devotees, this is also especially your place. All the rejects are staying here. But this place, the Siddhapakul, is a place of utmost importance to us. Why? Because it was the first place when the sound of Srila Rupa Goswami's poetry was revealed. In this, the first time in this day of Lord Brahma. One day, Rupa Goswami was staying there with Srila Haridas Thakur, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came with Swarup Damodar, Roy Ramananda, Paramananda Puri, and other associates. So Mahaprabhu sat up on a raised platform with his intimate associates, and Rupa Goswami and Srila Haridas Thakur, they sat down in a lower position. So at that time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to test Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and Roy Ramananda. Why? Actually, they are great scholars and great poets. They've written so much Sanskrit poetry. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu knew that the poetry that Rupa Goswami was writing would be unprecedented, no comparison at all. So Mahaprabhu wanted to hear Rupa Goswami's poetry so that Roy Ramananda and Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, they would hear it and he would see their reaction. Because they know the measure of what is good Sanskrit poetry, and they know what is the extent of the expression of aprakrita rasa, transcendental mellows. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, oh, Rupa Goswami, you can recite some of the verses that you're writing. So then Rupa Goswami, he read one verse. Tunde tandavani ratin vitanute tandavali labde kana kroda kadambani vitayate kana vodebra springam cheta prangana rangini vijayate savindriyami kritin no jani janita kirat piramita krishne divana dvai. I do not know how much amrita, how much nectar is in these two syllables, Krishna. When these two syllables, Krishna, come together, so much amrita is emanating from them that I think, oh, why did the Creator make me with only one tongue? I wanted millions and millions of tongues to taste this name. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna,
Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
And then when the sound of this name goes in my ear, it's somewhat improvement, because only one time, but 2 years, that's an improvement. But that 2 years is not enough. I wanted millions and millions of ears. And when that sound goes in the ear and then goes in my heart and begins to dance in the courtyard of my heart, then all the senses, they become stunned, inert, and one goes in samadhi, in trance. When Srila Haridas Thakur heard this poetry of Rupa Goswami, you see, Srila Haridas Thakur, he has experience, but he has not vocalized, he is not articulated. In fact, he never heard anyone articulate so beautifully the power of the holy name. And Srila Haridas Thakur jumped up and began to dance. He said, Krishna namera mohina shastre sadhu mukhi jani namera madhuri aichi kahan nahi shuni. Srila Haridas Thakur said, the glories of the holy name, which are written in Shastra, one must hear them from the lips of a pure devotee. Must hear from the lips of a pure devotee. Namera madhuri aichi kahan nahi shuni. There is no other place anywhere where you can catch the experience of the sweetness of Krishna's name. Only when you hear the Shastra and the glories of the name explain from the lips. Krishna Namero Mohima Shastri Sarumuki Jani. When you hear from this, then you know. Then you can understand something. Otherwise not. Why is that? In Srimad Bhagavatam, there it is said, Yetu Twadiya Charnam Bhuja Kosha Gandham Jigrantikana Vivarai Shuti Vartanitam Bhaktya Grihita Charna Pariyachatisham Na Paisinata Charnam Guruhat. And Suyogam, here Lord Brahma is saying, oh my Lord, the pure devotees, when they hear about you, when they chant about you, you appear, your lotus feet appear on the lotus of their heart, and you never leave them. This is real Sravan, this is real Kirtan. Real Sravan, real hearing, and real Kirtan means Spurti. To have a revelation in the pure heart. The chitta, which is very steady, not disturbed chitta. When the chitta is disturbed, then many desires appear. But when the chitta is steady, then it becomes very, very shining like a mirror. So it is said in Srimad Bhagavatam, Svachatvam Avikaritvam Shantamam Iti Chaitasa. The nature of the chitta is three things. Shantatvam means when the chitta is uncontaminated, one feels peacefulness. One has no desires. Avikaritvam means you don't feel sleepy and you don't feel distracted. And especially Svachatvam. Svachatvam means clear. It means Bhagavad Bimba Grahitvam. That this, the chitta has the capacity to catch the reflection of the form of the Lord. So as soon as the devotee, his heart is steady, is detached from this world, and yabilashita shunyam, not having any worldly desires, and peacefully chants the holy name, then the beautiful Swarupa of Shama Sunda is reflected in the mirror of the heart. And Krishna, he doesn't leave that devotee's heart. So, jigranti, kana vivarai sruti vata nitam. And those devotees, by listening to Harikatha, they smell the fragrance, the sweet aroma of Krishna's lotus feet through their ears. Generally, in this world, we smell through the nose. But if you want to smell the fragrance of Krishna's lotus feet, you have to smell through the ears. So how can you smell through the ears? Because the ears are listening to sound. But here, Sruti Vata Nitam means that the fragrance of Krishna's lotus feet is carried on the spiritual air of transcendental sound. So when a Vaishnava who has realized Krishna articulates the glories of Krishna, that Shabda Brahma, that transcendental sound vibration, is carrying the form of Krishna and the fragrance of Krishna's lotus feet. And those who will hear with respect, with honor, in a very humble mood, being surrendered at the lotus feet of their Gurudev, directly they experience Krishna. Sadyo ritya avarudete trakritibhisu srusabhistachanat. In the very beginning, second verse of Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said, this Srimad Bhagavatam is so powerful that even one who just desires to hear Srimad Bhagavatam, then immediately Krishna will come and be trapped in his heart and will not be able to leave. The word tachanat, tachanat, means in that very moment, there and then, tachanat, that moment. Also, chana, the word chana, means utsav, festival. In other words, that the discussion of Krishna's pastimes as they're described in Srimad Bhagavatam is so ecstatic. It's such a festival that Krishna himself wants to hear it. So as soon as you want to hear Srimad Bhagavatam, Krishna says, Jai, Jai. It's a festival time. And he runs and he sits down in your heart and he's waiting to listen to Srimad Bhagavatam. Harikatha is so powerful. So when Srila Rupa Goswami, he began to read his poetry, glorifying the holy name. Srila Haridas once got up and began to dance. He said, oh, you have to hear from the lips of a pure devotee. Then you can realize how sweet is Krishna's name. How sweet are Krishna's pastimes. So hearing this Ramananda Rai, he was astonished. He said, oh, Rupa, what kind of drama are you writing? It seems to be something unprecedented. Can you tell us how you've given pranam to your Ishtadev, the Mangalacharnam of your drama? How have you introduced the characters? You know, because in Vedic drama, there are so many rules. And in regard to the technique of expression of the drama, the Natakam should have 10 acts. It should be based on some historical, well-known story, which is found in the Shastra. There should be a hero, and the desire of the hero should be inspired by some situation, and he's striving to fulfill his goal. But then many obstacles should come, and then he should become completely discouraged and feel like it's a failure. And then something else should happen in the drama that gives him hope, and he becomes encouraged again. So these are the structures, the rules for writing the Vedic Natakam, Vedic dramas. So Ramananda Rai, he's very expert in all of these things. You know, there are 33 sanchari paths, 33 different types of transitory assisting emotions. So all of them, they should be there in the drama somewhere like that. Then it will be complete. When the audience see that drama, then they have a complete meal. You know, not just sweet, not just sour, but all the flavors of rasa should be there. So Ramananda Rai, he knows all these technical details of how to express rasa. So he was interested to know, how is Rupa Goswami writing this drama? Can you tell me? How do you give honor to your Ishtadev? Then Rupa Goswami, he became shy, he was embarrassed. Why? Because his Ishtadev is Mahaprabhu and he's sitting right there. Mahaprabhu said, don't be shy, you can read. Rupa Goswami said, Anarpita charim chirat karunaya bhakti naha kalo samarpayitum unnata kujvara rasam savakti sriyam hari purata sundara jyoti kadamba sandipita sadarida kandare spratuva sati nandana. May that son of Sati appear in the innermost cave of your heart. He has appeared in this Kali Yuga, resplendent with the radiance of molten gold, to give what no incarnation has ever given before in this day of Lord Brahma, out of his causeless mercy. Samarpaitum unnat ujvala rasa swapati sutam. Ujvala rasa, that is the romantic mood of Vrindavan, Madhuya rasa, swabhakti sriyam, and the beauty of that, which is Radha Dasyam, the mood of service to Srimati Radhika. So, when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu heard this, it was glorification of himself, he covered his ears. Oh, Sri Vishnu, Sri Vishnu, Sri Vishnu. He said, Rupa Goswami, your poetry is like amrita, like nectar. Why did you put in this drop of distasteful alkali? Little bit of poison in it. Why did you do that? Ramananda Rai stood up to the defense of Rupa Goswami. He said, no. This is not a drop of alkali. This is a touch of camphor to make the nectar more fragrant and more flavorful. So Ramananda Rai, he said, what is the use of the arrow of the bowman if it enters the heart but it does not cause the head to spin? So in the same way, what is the use of the poetry of the poets if it enters the heart but does not cause your head to spin? That means poetry should be so beautiful you become bewildered. Therefore, tene brahma ridaya adi kave bhuyanti yatsuraya. When the devotees, Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya, Roy Ramananda, Swarup Damodar Goswami, Paramananda Puri, when they heard the poetry of Rupa Goswami, their heads were spinning, bhuyanti yatsuraya. They felt that they would faint in ecstasy. So, Sadarida Kandura is Pratuva Sachinandana. May Sachinandan appear in your heart. Why is Rupa Goswami saying that? He's saying it because if someone tries to explain to you the pastimes of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they're so gambir. It's very difficult to understand. But if the beautiful golden form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will appear in your heart, only seeing his form, samarpayatum unnat uchinas. Jiva Goswami in his commentary on this verse, he said, actually, there's no question of Mahaprabhu giving this Madhurya Rasa and anyone taking it. There's no act of giving and no act of receiving. There's only this. Sadharidaya kandares paratuva sachinanana. If you just see the golden complexion of Mahaprabhu, then you receive it. Only seeing him. There's many examples. You know, when Mahaprabhu was in Puri and he wanted to go to Vrindavan, very humbly, he said to Swarup Damodara Ramananda, please, for a long time I wanted to go to Vrindavan, but every year you by some trick you keep me here in Puri. So now I'm asking you, give me permission, let me go to Vrindavan. So then they said, yes, yes, you should go, but if you want to please us, then please take a Brahmin with you who can carry your kamandalu, your water pots and your fresh cloth, who can go begging in the village and prepare some food for you. So Mahaprabhu, he agreed, and they selected the Balabhadra Bhattacharya to go with him. So when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was leaving Puri, many of the devotees followed him. Actually, they followed him as far as Katak, to the that was the capital of Orissa at that time. So the king of Puri, Prataparudra Maharaj, he heard that Mahaprabhu was going to Vrindavan, and he was very eager to serve him in every way. So he told his servants, oh, you should prepare some houses in the village, so each time Mahaprabhu stops in the evening time, he should stay in a newly prepared place with his associates. And you should bring Mahaprasadam from Jagannath Puri, so he can take Jagannath Prasadam in each village as he's going through Orissa. He told his associates, when he gets to a river, you should make sure that there's a special beautiful boat decorated with flags to take him across whenever he needs to cross the river, like the Chitrapal River. Also, Prataparudra Maharaj told his associates, and wherever Mahaprabhu takes bath in a river, then you should make a monument, make a stone monument there and say, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took bath here in this river. Maharaj Prataparudra said, and I will go there, and I will also take bath there. It will become a holy place. What to speak of that? I want to die on the bank of the river where Mahaprabhu has taken bath. So in this way, he was expressing his love for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and trying to serve Mahaprabhu as much as he could in every way possible. So, but then he thought, oh, he's a sannyasi. So actually the ladies, the queens and the princesses in my palace, they've never had his association, they haven't seen him. So I want to arrange some opportunity that they should have the darshan of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Maharaj Prataparudra, he knew along which road Mahaprabhu would be coming to go to the next village. So he arranged some elephants. And on the back of the elephants, he made some tents, platform with a tent on it, completely covered, cloth on all sides. And the ladies of the palace, the princesses and queens of his palace, they were all hidden inside the tents on the backs of the elephants, and they're on the side of the road. Then Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, walking along the road, singing the glories of the Lord. Krishna Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Hare.
Krishna Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Hare. Krishna Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Krishna,
inside the tents, they were peeping through the cloth. And from far away, they saw Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And only seeing the golden form of Mahaprabhu long arms reaching down to his knees, his lotus eyes reaching around to his ears, tears washing his body, his soft golden body, soft like butter, so effulgent, absorbed in Radha Bhav, in the mood of Radharani, he's going to Vrindavan, feeling so much separation from Krishna in Radha Bhav. So when those queens inside the tents, they saw Chaitanya Mahaprabhu from far away, immediately they became overwhelmed with praying, they began to cry and they fainted and fell to the ground. Emona kripala nahi shuni tribhuvane Krishna prema hoy jay dur darshane. Shri Krishna Sagar Goswami said, never ever in all the three worlds has anyone heard of someone so merciful as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Even those who would see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu from far away, they would attain Krishna prema. So this is samarpayitum unnata uchvara. Only seen before. Why? How is it possible
that one gets praying simply by seeing Chaitanya Mahaprabhu without taking shelter of Rupa Goswami? No one would understand. No one would understand. We want to explain, how is it that one attains Krishna praying just from the darshan of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Why is that? Srila Rupa Goswami in Ujjala Nilamani, he describes the Mahabhav of Srimati Radhika. Anuraga so sambhavya dasha prapa prakashita yavat ashraya vichis chet bhav itya vidhiyate. Mahabhav, the highest love of Radhika, has three prominent qualities. First is the swasambhavya dasha. That is that when Radhika sees the sweetness of Krishna, she becomes so absorbed in that sweetness that she forgets who she is. Naso ramana nahava ramani dumanu manubhava peshwajani. Radhika said, I am not his lover and he is not my beloved. Cupid has melted our hearts and we have become one. So seeing the sweetness of Krishna, Radhika forgets everything. And she becomes lost in that sweetness. But because of her anurag, the nature of Radhika's love is A prema dori nitya Radhika ekale amara madhurya mrita ashwade sokale. It is the nature of Radhika's love that Krishna's sweetness is in, she sees that it's increasing at every moment. Everyone doesn't see like that. But her anurag makes Krishna appear newer and newer every moment. And then when Krishna's sweetness increases, then her taste for that increases and her anurag increases. So then Krishna's sweetness, his sweetness is increasing, her anurag is increasing like this. They're competing with each other unlimitedly, without end. This is called swasambhavya dasha. Then prakashita means that Radhika's hair is standing, tears flowing, her body is trembling, her complexion is fading, she's becoming stunned. All eight sattvic bhavs come at the same time, very intensive, called prakashita. And then the last one, yavad ashray briti. Yavad ashray briti means that the love of Radhika is so powerful that it spreads out in all directions and affects everyone all around her, in proportion to the degree of their relationship with her. So everyone is affected, but to different degrees. So that is called Yavad Ashray Vritti. Srila Rupa Goswami has revealed in Ujjala Nilamani, this is of two types. One type is called Brahmanda Shobha Karita, that the love of Radhika, when she's in separation, makes a disturbance throughout the whole universe. When Krishna's gone to Mathura, Radhika sits on the bank of Jamuna and wraps herself in Krishna's pitambara, yellow cloth, and cries, Ananda Kula Chandra Maha Kwasi Ki Chandra Kalankriti Kwamanda Murali Ravaha Kwanu Surendra Nila Juti Kwarasura Sutandavi Kwasa ki jiva rakshaushati nidhi mama suritama patahanta divini. Oh my Sakhi, where did Krishna go? Where is he who is like a moon, who appeared in the dynasty of Nanda Maharaj, whose complexion is like a brilliant sapphire, whose notes upon his flute are so deep and so sweet, who is like a medicine to save my life? I am dying without him. Oh Sakhi, please bring Krishna that medicine to save my life. Alas, alas, Lord Brahma Vidhi, the creator, providence, he is written in my fate that I have to cry. And when he is weeping this way, everyone becomes disturbed. Her Sakhis are fainting. The bumblebees, they give up the flower, they don't take the honey from the flowers anymore, and they roll on the ground weeping. Even the fish in the Jamuna cry. Even the demigods in the heavenly planets, they begin to perspire. Even Lakshmi Devi in Vaikuntha begins to cry. In other words, the power of Radhika's love for Krishna, this Mahabharata, is so intense, it spreads out and disturbs the entire universe. This is one of the symptoms of Radhika's Mahabharata, Yavadashray Vritti, Pramanda Shobhakarita. And there's another symptom. The other symptom is called Asan Janita Ridvilolan. It means that it churns the hearts of those who are close enough to Radhika either to see or to hear her. So this is very, very important point for the followers of Rupa Goswami. Why is that? Because there are some bhavs, some ecstasies of Radhika, which can only be felt. Goswami, he said, Bhadjayos Bina Paradasyameva. Oh, Srimati Radhika, I never ask you for anything. I only want to be your maid servant. I bow down to your sakis, your friends like Lalita and Vishakha again and again. They are worshipful for me. I eternally bow down to them, but I don't want to be like them. That means Lalita and Vishakha, they are the contemporaries of Radhika, same age, they're her friends. But when Radhika meets with Sri Krishna, she becomes shy in the presence of the Lalita and Vishakha. So to give Radhika the space to meet with Krishna in an uninhibited way, then the Lalita and Vishakha, they retreat and they go into the distance. They meet on the bank of Jamuna, they sit down beneath the Kadamba tree, they talk with each other. But when Radha and Krishna go into the kunjas of Vrindavan, at that time, Rupa Manjari, Rati Manjari, the maid servants of Radhika, they can go into the kunja and serve in so many ways. So sometimes they wait outside because Vrindadevi arranges that in the kunja there's a ceiling fan and it's connected to a rope and then the rope goes outside. So then the maid servants of Radhika, they may sit outside and then they pull the string like this to keep Radha Krishna cool during their loving pastimes. So sometimes they don't see, but they can hear the sound of the ankle bells of Radhika. They can hear the sound of Radha Krishna's pastimes. And being close enough only to hear, then Radhika's Mahabharata completely vyapt means pervades them. Radhika's Madanaki Mahabharata, which no one has, not Chandravani, nor the Gopi, not even Lalita, not even the Shaka, it pervades the made sounds of Radhika from head to toe because of Yavadashray Vritti, the spreading out of her bark to those who can hear or those also close enough to see. So, because Krishna appears in this world as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he's in Radha Bhag. So when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is chanting the holy name in the mood of Radhika, then Yavadashray Vritti, that potency is there, that Radhika's bark is spreading out. And those who are close enough to see, then they become inundated in that. And that's why the wives of Prataburda Maharaj, they're all fainting. Only seeing Mahaprabhu from far away. If Srila Rupa Goswami Pad had not explained these things, no one would know. They'll just think, oh, okay, it sounds okay. But Rupa Goswami is explaining how these are the symptoms of Radhika's mood. So, we just start, is it okay? What time can we go till? 8:26, when, how long do we go on here?
Nine.
9 o'clock. So, Srila Rupa Goswami, he said, in regard to Srila Rupa Goswami, he said, Sri Chaitanya Manovishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale. All the confidential secrets of Radha Krishna's Leela, the bhavs of Radhika, no one knew them. No one could understand them. This love, even no one had heard the name of this love. What is Mananaki Mahabharata? But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu inspired this into the heart of Srila Rupa Goswami. So then Ramananda Raya and the others, this poetry is very beautiful. Can you tell us some more of this very beautiful poetry? So then Rupa Goswami continued to read. Pida bi navakala kuta katata garvasya nirvasano nisyandena mudam sudamuduri mahankara sampochana prema sundari nandanandana paro jagati asyantare jayante smutamasya vakramaturas jena eva vikrantaya. Srimati Radhika is young. She's just started to fall in love with Krishna. Whenever she sees a peacock feather, she starts to tremble. If anyone mentions, talks about deer in the forest, the black deer in the forest are called Krishnasar. Yeah. If someone mentions Krishnasar, then Radharani starts crying uncontrollably. Her mother-in-law, Jyotira, is thinking, what happened to my daughter-in-law? She's acting very strange, trembling, crying. Is she sick? So Jyotira went to Purnamasi Devi and said to Purnamasi Devi, I think that my daughter-in-law has become sick. She must have some illness. Purnamasi Devi said, don't be worried. I'll take care of this. Jyotira didn't understand that what Purnamasi would take care of is that she would arrange that Krishna would meet with Radhika. So Nandimukhi's daughter, granddaughter of Purnamasi. She asked, what's wrong with Radhika? Then Purnamasi said, Pida Vina Vakala Kuta Katata. Oh, you don't know? She has Krishna praying, love for Krishna. And only one who has experienced this love for Krishna can know what it's like. This love for Krishna, Vikrantaya, it attacks your heart. And it is like Pida Vina Vakala Kuta Katata. It's so painful. It's the pain that it causes defeats the pain caused by the fresh poison of a serpent. But at the same time, the sweetness of this pain defeats the ego of Amrita from the heavenly planets being poured upon your head. And so when this Krishna prema appears in the heart, it's like a mixture of poison and nectar. When Rupa Goswami said this, oh, Ramananda Raya, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, everyone, they are amazed. What a beautiful expression of Krishna brain. Oh, Rupa Goswami, tell us more. So in this way, Srila Rupa Goswami, he said, Akarunya Krishna Yadi Maitavarga Katavidam Mudama Rodi Meikuru Paramimam Mutar Kritim Kamalasya Skandevi Nihita Buja Valeri Riyam Yuta Brindaranye Chiramma Vichala Tishka Kitanu. Rupa Goswami described how Radhika, when she fell in love with Krishna, she was thinking, how can I meet with him? I should write a love letter to Krishna. So Radhika wrote a love letter and gave it to a Sakhi, and that Sakhi went to deliver it to Krishna. So when Krishna received this letter, he opened it, and then he said, oh, this is very bad. This is very bad. This is against Dharma. I cannot meet with this girl. And you can ask Madhu Mandal. I am a very Paka Brahmachari. I am always following Dharma very strictly. And Krishna refused. So then that friend of Radhika came back to Krishna and came back to Radhika and told her, I gave him the letter, but he rejected. Then Radharani became completely depressed. And she went on to the bank of the Jamuna. And she said to her friend Vishakha, oh, Vishakha, I want to give you this. And Radhika took off her necklace and gave her necklace to Vishakha. Vishakha immediately began to cry. Why? Because in Vedic culture, before you die, you distribute your valuable items to your loved ones. So when Radhika gave her necklace to Vishakha, then Vishakha realized, oh, she wants to die. So she said, Akarunya Krishna, Krishna Yadima Itavada Katavidam. Oh Vishakha, if Krishna is not merciful to me, then there's no need for you to cry because it's not your fault. It's not your fault, so you shouldn't cry. But Vishakha, I'm just asking one thing for you. What is that? Can you perform my funeral ceremony? What funeral ceremony? Tamalasya Skande. Radharani said, okay, if I cannot meet with Krishna, at least when I die, I want you to wrap my arms around the tamal tree on the bank of Jamuna. And so I can just forever just hold on to a tamal tree because the complexion is similar to Krishna. No one had ever written such poetry before like this. All the devotees, Muyanti Yatsuraya, they were fainting in ecstasy, hearing the words of Srila Rupa Goswami. I want to make just one point, very deep and very important point. So I request, please, with your full attention, hear very, very carefully. Srila Rupa Goswami, in his poetry, in his plays, in Ujjwala Nilamani, he describes the nature of brain, love, and how that love grows. It becomes sneha, affection. It becomes man, sometimes crooked. And Radharani becomes in a contrary mood. It becomes pranay, feelings of oneness. It becomes rag, anurag, bhav, mahabhav, rudabhav, adirudabhav. And it goes to the highest point, Radharani's mood, that is called madanaki mahabhav. Madan. So, what is that? We have heard this word, Madanaki Mahabhav. Everyone has heard it, right? You've heard this one? Right? That's Radhika. That's the thing that makes Radharani special, right? That makes Radharani superior to Chandravali and all the rival groups. It makes her superior to Lalita and Vishakha. Right? That's the uniqueness of Radhika is Madanaki Mahabhav. But I have a question. What is it? What is Madanbhav? Anyone will tell? Can you explain what it is?
Krishna's love.
All brain, snare, man, all is love. So, actually no one knew. No one knew. No one understood. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu inspired in the heart of Rupa Goswami. This is the meaning. Sri Chaitanya Mano Vishtam. Rupa Goswami realized what Mahaprabhu came in this world to experience. And he revealed to others what was Mahaprabhu's mission here, what he came to experience and distribute. When Rupa Goswami is describing the Madan Bhav, he gives two verses. First verse, he quotes from Srimad Bhagavatam. Puna pulinda uragaya padabjaraga Shri kumkumena daitastana manditena Thadarshana stana ujjatina rushitena Limpanta anana kucheshu ja ustadadhi. My life is not successful. My life is a failure. But you know whose life is purna, complete, purna, successful Purna Pulindi Urudaya Patakchara. The Pulindi girls, they're like Aborigine Adivasis. They live in the forest. Not the outside of baby culture. They're not civilized. They collect wood and sell it to the villages. They're not even clean. They don't wear nice ornaments. They're not beautiful or anything. But Radharani is saying, Purna, Purna, Pulindi, their life is successful. Why? Because one day they looked on the grass, the blades of grass at Govardhan Hill, and they saw some kumkum. Kumkum is the cosmetics that is made on the body of Vraja Gopi. So see, Krishna meeting with the Gopi, that Gopi had taken his lotus feet and held on her heart. Because that is called the prastavna. That is the first act or the introduction. The introduction to loving pastimes is that the heroine, first she holds her lover's feet on her heart, after that all the other pastimes. So, the kumkum from the body of that gopi came on the feet of Krishna. Afterwards, when he was returning home, he walked on the grass at Govardhan and it was smeared there. So some Pulindi girls, Aborigine girls, they didn't even see Krishna, but they just saw that kumkum and they took that from the grass and they rubbed it on their faces and on their bodies. And when they saw the kumkum, they were afflicted with lust. They became so lusty. But when they touched that kumkum to their faces and bodies, they became completely satisfied. So Radharani is speaking this. I don't have love. They have love. My life is not successful, but their life is successful because they have touched this kumkum from the feet of Krishna. So Rupa Goswami gives this example of Madanva. Just note it down in your heart. Just remember that. It will give some idea. So then Rupa Goswami gives another example. Duskaram katra dali marati komalayam akkaratta papura hanta gostapati nandanopama jatamalopa upaguhate. Radharani is saying to one Sakhi, she's saying, oh Sakhi, can you see this jasmine vine? There's a very delicate jasmine vine, malati vine, here. You think that this malati vine is very soft, but you should know that in the previous life, this malati vine did kathor tapasya, very, very hard austerities. What is the proof? What is the evidence? Because this malati vine is wrapped around a tamal tree, whose complexion is similar to Krishna's complexion. So this is an astonishing thing. One of the symptoms of Madanva is that Radhika has so much love for Krishna that not only does she think that anything in connection with Krishna is glorious and successful, but anything which is just in connection to something which slightly resembles Krishna is completely successful. So because the tamal tree, its complexion is similar to Krishna's complexion, she's thinking this vine of the jasmine vine touching that tree, oh, must have done so many austerities in the previous life to embrace that which is just similar to Krishna. This is the astonishing emotions that Radhika is experiencing. But now a problem comes. And the problem is this. Radhika spoke these words about the Pulindi girls in separation from Krishna. And she's speaking to Asaki, one of her friends. Radharani spoke this glorification of the jasmine vine in separation from Krishna. And she's speaking to her friend. But Rupa Goswami has written, Yoga eva bhaved esha vichitra kopi madhanaha yad vilasa virajante nitya lila sahasradaha. It means that this Madanva only appears at the time of meeting. In other words, Madana Kimabhag never manifests in separation. Madana Kimabhag only manifests at the time of the meeting of Radha and Krishna, when they are together. So why is it that Srila Rupa Goswami Pada has given two verses? Both of these verses are spoken by Radhika when she's separated to Krishna, from Krishna. They're not spoken to Krishna, they're spoken to Sati. Does everyone understand the question? Everyone's following. We're all on the same page. If you understand where we are so far, you just raise your hand. It gives me encouragement. Thank you. So, this is the question. Rupa Goswami is saying, Madan Bhav only comes when Radha Krishna together. But the two examples he gave, they're both spoken at the time of separation, and not to Krishna, but to one friend of Radha. So, what is the reconciliation? Yad vilas virajante nitya lila sahasra saha. It means this. Perhaps you know that the pastimes of Krishna are going on in so many universes. Right? You know Krishna's pastimes, they move from universe to universe. That's prakat, manifest. But the aprakat is always there. In every universe, millions of universes, there's a planet Earth. On every planet Earth, there's a Vrindavan. And in every Vrindavan, either prakat manifests to everyone, or aprakat unmanifests from everyone, Radha Krishna's Leela is going on. Right? So, how many, that dimension where the Leela is going on is called a prakash. So, how many prakash? How many prakashes are there where Radha Krishna's Leela is going on? Unlimited. Millions and millions are unlimited. Not only in the material world, but in the spiritual world, Vrindavan there also has unlimited prakash. Now, in each Vrindavan, Krishna is there, Nanda Maharaj is there, Yashoda Maya is there, Madhu Mangal is there, Subhav, Sri Dham, Dham, Vasu Dham, Arjuna Bhangastok with Krishna, Basant, Kokyo, Bhrindya, so many covered bodies, the Lita Vishaka. They're all there in every prakash, right? And so there's also millions of Yashodas, millions of Nanda Maharaj. But one mystery is this, that each Brijvasi, each associate of Krishna in each prakash thinks I'm only in that one prakash. You understand? So let's say Mother Yashoda is in this universe. She knows I'm Mother Yashoda and here. Krishna's my baby, I'm taking care of him. She's not aware that she's also present in another universe and another universe. So this is called in our Gaudiya philosophy prakash bhed, abhiman bhed. Abhiman means your identity of who you think you are, who you know you are. That's your abhiman, your identity. So prakash bhed, abhiman bhed. That means in each different prakash bhed, each associate has abhiman bhed. They think I am this person here. They don't know about any of the other prakash. Understand? Prakash bhed, abhiman bhed. Because if they knew, then there would be no sweetness in the liver. Because Krishna's Leela is Naravat, it's human-like. Mother Yashoda thinks, I'm a queen of this village, I'm a human being, I'm only whatever, I'm so old, and I have one son, my only child, Krishna. He's very hungry, I have to feed him my breast milk, if I don't feed him, he'll become skinny. Like this. She's thinking like this, very human-like. If you were to suddenly realize, oh, I'm in this universe, and that, then you won't think you're human anymore, right? Because it's superhuman. So in the Vrindavan Leela, Prakash Bhed, Abhiman Bhed. Everyone's identity is just limited to that one Prakash, that one Dhamma. Now, what happens is, that's true also in Radha Krishna Leela. When Krishna's meeting with Radhika, he thinks, I'm a coward boy. I'm the son of Nanda Maharaj. Like this. He never thinks he's Bhagavan, because praying, the power of praying makes Krishna forget everything. He thinks he's an ordinary boy. And Radhika thinks, I'm a gopi, I'm a cowherd girl living in this village, and when I was a little girl, I fell in love with Krishna, but then a big problem came, because my marriage was arranged to Abhimanyu, so now I have to live in Yavat with his dysfunctional family, Jutila and Kutila and Abhimanyu. They were always trying to control me. I can't meet with Krishna. I have to sneak out and meet with Krishna secretly. Otherwise, they'll discover and there'll be a big scandal in the village and it will be so terrible. Right? So this is all, this is none of our human life. So Radhika feels like an ordinary girl. Krishna feels like a natural boy. That is Madhurya Lila. But when Radhika's love goes up to praise Naya Man Panaya Rag Anurag Bhav Mahabhav Buddha Bhav Adi Buddha Bhav Mohan Bhav Modan Bhav Mohan, and last, when it comes to Madanaki Mahabhav, something wonderful happens. When Radhika is in the embrace of Sri Krishna, when Madanaki Mahabhav manifests, then in one prakash, the emotions from so many hundreds and thousands of other prakashis, they begin to overflow and come into the heart of Radhika in one prakash. So even though she's in the embrace of Krishna and she's with him in another universe, she's crying and telling her Sakhi, oh, I am so unfortunate, but these Pulindi girls, they're fortunate. In another universe, she's telling her Sakhi, oh, I cannot meet with Krishna, but this jasmine vine embracing this tree is fortunate. In another universe, she's embracing Krishna. In another universe, Krishna's gone to Mathura and she's speaking with the bumblebee. Like this. So in this way, in one prakash, Radhika is embracing Krishna, but emotions from hundreds of leelas, nitya leela sahasrada, they begin to leak into her consciousness and she begins to speak like a mad person. So Srila Rupa Goswami has said, Smara Vilasita Talpai Jalpalilam Analpam Kritam Akrita Virupam Te Vibrate Kaina Sardam Mito Yama Pariramba Ramba Vritaika Varshma Shanama Pima Radha Krishna Radha Krishna Anandayatvam. He's saying, Smara Vilasita Talpai Jalpalila Manapam. When Radha Krishna embracing the Kunja Vrindavan, at that time, Radharani begins to speak. Jalpa. Jalpalila Manapam. She's speaking so much. And what is she saying? Kramakrita Parihinam. Her words, her sentences, they have no connection, they have no sequence to each other. Right? Because so many emotions from here and there are coming and she's speaking it. And Krishna is looking and hearing what Radhika is saying and he cannot understand what she's saying or why she's saying all of these things. And Krishna is thinking, what's going on? What is she feeling? I don't know. I wish I knew what she was feeling. And because he had such an intense greed to know what she was feeling, therefore he appeared as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Yeah.
Understand? Therefore, he said, Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale. No one knew why Krishna appeared as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What is was with his Manobhishta, his innermost feeling, why he came here. But Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadhamayam Dadati Swapadantikam. Sri Rupa Goswami, step by step, explained everything from Shraddha, Nishtha, Ruchi, Asakti, Bhav, what is the Sadhan Bhakti, Bhava Bhakti, Prema Bhakti, then Sneha, Man, Prana, all the levels of Prem, all the way up to that highest mood, to the Madan Bhav. Then, when a person is absorbed, sinking in the nectar of Rupa Goswami's Katha, then they can understand why Mahaprabhu came here. Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Stapitam. So we cannot. We can never repay Srila Rupa Goswami. The contribution he has made is unprecedented. Therefore, our Gurudev, with great pride, he used to say, we are Rupanuga. Rupanuga, the followers of Srila Rupa Goswami. So in the beginning of the class, I mentioned, Gora Ami, Muki Bali Nahi Chali, Gora Acha, Gora Vichal, Hare Pali Pali. Many persons say, I am Gaudiya, the follower of Mahaprabhu. From their mouth, they tell. But Gaur Achar Gaura Vichar, unless we do bhajan, take shelter of the holy name, as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu set the example in his whole life, and Gaura Vichar, unless we go deeply into the teachings of Mahaprabhu that were revealed through the writing of Rupa Goswami, then we are not actually Gaudiya. Understand? Not, yes, and hear from the lips of pure Vaishnava. Then we can enter into this. So in this way, when Srila Gurudev used to glorify Rupa Goswami, it was as if he had five mouths. He could not stop. And so though Srila Gurudev is not physically present in this world, those who are his disciples and those who are Rupanuga, they should not lose their time in the mundane things. They should not lose their time in only Katara, Vaidhi Bhakti and all of this. But rather, what has Srila Rupa Goswami given? Once Gurudev told me, I was alone with him actually in one hotel room. We were just passing through with Los Angeles. And he called me. He said, pray Roger, come here. So I sat at his feet. Gurudev said, if you want to please me, then just try to understand what is a Shuddha Bhakti. What is pure devotion? What Srila Rupa Goswami has given? Enter into these things. By this you can please me. So if you want to please our Gurudev, if you want to please our whole Guru Parampara and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, don't lose your time in any external things. Because this just this one drop that was on the end of Rupa Goswami's finger that he tasted, it will take you your whole life just to touch the surface of that. So we want to always, we pray to Gurudev and our acharyas that we can come together. Sajataya Shaisnidhe Srimad Bhagavatatanam Asudo Rasika Saha Sajataya Shaisnidhe Sadhu Sangha Swato Bhare. Rupa Goswami said, one should taste the many meanings of each word, each syllable of Srimad Bhagavatam in the association of Rasik Vaishnavas. That association should have three qualities. One, Bhare, should be significantly more advanced than ourselves. Snigde means should have affection for us. That affection means that we have served that Vaishnava, we are related to with that Vaishnava in such a way that he has decided, you will be my Kripa Patra. That means you will be the recipient of my mercy. So with such Vaishnavas who have affection for us, and Sajataya Ashaye means associating with those Vaishnavas whose Ashay, that means the inner region of their heart, is perfect and realized and filled with the very desires and the service that we are aspiring for. So if one is aspiring for the service of Radha and Krishna, we should be in the association of devotees who are in that mood, Rupanuga, following the mood of Srila Rupa Goswami. And in this way, gradually, Krishnam smaram janam tasya pristam nija smitam tat tat katar tascaso kuryad vasam brajai sada. Rupa Goswami said, the first practice of Radhanuga Bhakti is to constantly remember Sri Krishna along with that associate that you want to follow, in whose footsteps you want to serve. Tat tat katar tascaso. Always be absorbed in the katar concerning Radha Krishna and that particular associate. And always, if you cannot physically be there, at least in your heart you should think I'm in Vrindavan, on the bank of Yamuna, in the lap of Viraj Govardhan, on the bank of Radha. Always stay there. And in this way, gradually, one's bhakti can mature through the stages. And naturally, not by imagination, but by internal realization, the Siddha Rupa. One Siddha Rupa will appear, and then one can internally serve. So in this way, I offer my Sharda Pushpanji at the lotus feet of Srila Gurudev, at the lotus feet of Srila Rupa Goswami Pad, and I am praying for their mercy, that I can always remain in very high class sadhu sangha and be absorbed in the achar and the vichar, the behavior and the deep philosophical conclusions of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Hare, 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 hare,
devotees have some questions on the subject. Because we're now inside one very beautiful bubble, Vrindavan bubble. I don't want to go outside. So if you have a question on this subject,
yes, Prabhu.
So my heart stopped when Krishna rejected Srimati Radharani. So even though you went and explained Maharaniki Mahabhav, I wasn't fully there because I stopped. Can you please continue and tell us how that rascal, how he changed from Brahmachari and accept Srimati Radharani, please?
The reason, see, Krishna. I want to write a letter to Radhika, but it should be very romantic. So to write a romantic letter, you should have romantic ink. So it will go to Prashkanta.